Namaskar. The topic of discussion in this lesson is on the geography of Goa. India is a land of diversities. The geography of India is an essential aspect to be understood by every student in this country. As a nation, India occupies a very significant position in the world. It is a country known for its unique culture, history, heritage, natural resources, and human capital. India is a union of states. Each part of India is unique in its geography and socio-economic conditions. Goa is one of the prominent states in India. The main objectives of learning this lesson are to know about its geographic setting, people, governance, and contribution in the country. The aspects which are covered in this module are the physiographic setting, the climate, rainfall, and land cover, the administrative divisions and population, the economic resources and contributors, culture, tourism, and unique features of the state as a whole.
The physiographic setting. Goa lies between the northern latitude of 14° 53′ 54″ and 15° 40′ 00″ and eastern longitudes of 73° 40′ 33″ and 74° 20′ 13″. Most of Goa is a part of the coastal country known as the Konkan, which is an escarpment rising up to the Western Ghats range of mountains, which separates it from the Deccan Plateau Sonsagar with an altitude of 1167 meters is the highest point in the region. Goa has a coastline of 101 kilometers. Goa, though famous for its beaches, is essentially a rugged, hilly and mountainous tract with narrow valleys and sandy linear plains along the coast. The Western Ghats run in a north-south direction from Salgan to Surla Ghat along the eastern margin of the territory. This segment of Sahyadri ranges are clad with evergreen forests with altitude ranging from 600 meter to over 800 meter. The highest peak, Mamai Devi, is 832 meter height. In the western margin of the territory, there are long and narrow strips of sandy plains and low flat topped laterite hills ranging in altitude from 50 meter to 100 meter. Goa is home to some of the finest sea beaches in the country. The terrain is undulating with alternate chain of hills and long narrow valleys. The hills range in altitude from 250 meter to 400 meters. The Vagiri Hill near Valpoi is located much to the west of the Western Ghats and is connected by a narrow link with the Surla Ghat. The eastern border of the state generally marks the water divide between easterly and westerly flowing rivers. Languages spoken in Goa are Konkani 57.13%, Marathi 22.57%, Hindi 5.70%, Kannada 5.54% and others 9.06%. The climate, rainfall, land cover and religions. Lying in the tropical zone and sharing close proximity to the Arabian Sea, Goa witnesses hot and humid climate almost throughout the year. May is the hottest month of the year with maximum temperature scaling up to 35 degrees Celsius. However, there are no climate extremities in the state. The monsoon rains arrive by early June and provides a much needed respite from the heat. Monsoons are the source of Goa's annual rainfall, which lasts till late September. Goa has a short winter season between mid-December and February. These months are marked by nights of around 21 degrees Celsius and days of around 28 degrees Celsius with moderate amounts of humidity. In further inland, due to altitudinal gradation, the nights are a few degrees cooler. The monsoon in Goa arrives early in June and is one of the best seasons to witness the ecstatic beauty of Goa. With an annual rainfall of around 2,800 to 3,500 millimeter between the months of June and September, Goa is one of the most agriculturally blessed lands in the country. The geographic area of the state is about 3,702 kilometer square, of which the forest cover alone is about 1,224 kilometer square. The jungles of Goa are full of herbs and medicinal plants. Hinduism and Christianity are the most popularly practiced religions in the state. However, other religions like Islam and Sikhism are also prevalent in the state. The percentage of different religions prevalent in the state are Hinduism 65%, Christianity 30%, Islam 3%, Sikhism 2%. The administrative divisions, population and education. For administrative purposes, the state has been divided into two districts, North Goa District and South Goa District. Goa has a unicameral legislature consisting of a 40-member legislative assembly, headed by a chief minister who wields the executive power. The ruling government consists of the party or coalition capturing the most states in the state elections and enjoying the support of a single majority of the House. People of Goa are represented at the Union Government by one MP in the Rajya Sabha and two MPs in the Lok Sabha. Panaji, the state capital is located on the banks of the river Mandavi, and Vasco da Gama, Madgoa, Mapusa and Fonda are other major cities. The largest city of the state is Vasco da Gama. Population. The population of Goa is 14,57,723 in the country. The population density of the state is 394 persons per square kilometer. The sex ratio of Goa is 968 females to 1000 males. This ratio is higher than the national average of 940 females to 1000 males. The state has a birth rate of 13.5% per 1000 people per year and a death rate of 6.7%. The state's literacy rate has shown a gradual increase from 82.01% in 2001 to 87.40% in 2011, with male literacy at 92.81% and female at 81.84%. Education. Goa University is the premier center of higher studies in the state and most of the colleges are affiliated to it. There are also many medical and engineering colleges in the state. BITS Pilani in Goa is also a renowned institute which grants admission to the students on the basis of their performance in the All India Aptitude Test conducted by the institute. Some of the colleges in Goa also offer courses in arts, commerce, science, law, architecture, dentistry, marine engineering, hotel management, fisheries and pharmacy. NCAOR and NIO are the two national oceanographic science institutes situated at Vasco and Panjim in Goa. Goa Institute of Management, established in the year 1993, is a famous B school of the region. Students willing to pursue their undergraduate and postgraduate degree in Portuguese may do it from the Goa University. Geology, economic resources and contributors. Geologically, the state constitutes the northwesterly extension of the granitoid greentone terrane of Karnataka, comprising rocks of Precambrian age, viz. Gneisses, migmatites, granitoids, granites, schists, metavolcanics, metagraywacke, banded ferruginous quartzites associated with magniferous phyllites or argillites, limestones, dolomites and thin bands of quartzite intruded by granite and morphic to ultramorphic complex. Deccan Trap is exposed on the northeastern border of Goa. Peninsular gneisses are well exposed in Anmodgad section along the Panaji Fonda Londa highway. The rocks of Peninsular gneisses complex and Goa group are intruded by mafic to ultramafic complexes. Zuari and Mandovi are the biggest rivers of Goa. Economy. Goa is the richest state, with its GDP per capita 2.5 times that of the country as a whole. Goa is well endowed with economic mineral deposits, particularly iron and manganese ores. The in-situ reserves of about 967 million tons of the hematite, 187 million tons of magnetite and 83.1 million tons of manganese ore respectively constitute 8%, 3.08% and 22.4% of the total resources estimated for the country. Because of their proximity to the seaport, they are being mined extensively for export. Besides iron and manganese, a number of deposits of bauxite, silica sand, low-grade limestone, clays, low-grade chromite and quartzite are also extensively found in Goa. Agriculture forms the major economic activity of the state. Rice is the major agricultural crop. The other important crops are paddy, ragi, maize, jowar, bajra and pulses. The important cash crops grown here are coconut, cashew nut, areca nut, mango, jackfruit, banana, pineapple, etc. The important forest products are bamboo sticks, bhirand. Fishing industry is another major economic activity in the state and it employs several thousands of people. But nowadays, traditional fishing is replaced by large-scale mechanized trawling. The popular seafoods and fishes found are lobsters, crabs, jellyfish, shrimp, catfish, oysters, etc. The monsoon crops are called the kharif and the winter crops are called rabi. The main sources of irrigation for winter crops are the nalas, rivers, streams, tanks, wells, canal, etc. Sugarcane is also cultivated here. There is also a sugar factory in Goa. Cashew is an important crop in Goa. Feni, an exhilarating drink, is produced from cashew. There are a variety of mangoes grown here. Some of the varieties of mango grown here are Fernandine, Xavier, Alfonso, Colasso, etc. The two varieties of jackfruit are grown here, namely Capo and Razal. The prime vegetables grown here are brinjal, lady's finger, sweet potatoes, chilies, onions, radish, cucumber, pumpkins, drumsticks, breadfruit and different varieties of gourds. Culture, history, tourism and unique features of the state. One of the youngest states of the Indian Union, Goa was a colonial ruled by state for many centuries, and its history dates back to the 3rd century. The Goan culture consists of a mixture of the Portuguese and Indian lifestyles. The Portuguese were known to be the most wonderful church constructors, and so the location is marked with innumerable churches besides the temples, which were further constructed by later civilizations. Music is considered to be an integral part of the lives of Goan inhabitants. Apart from the local Konkani music and songs from different parts of the country, one can even hear Portuguese music and the popular trance of Goa, which is assumed to wind away into the listener's heart. Music is at every step in Goa, from the soul relaxing sound of the church bells in the early hours in the morning to the mandu songs in the evening. On the other hand, dance is known to be an additional part of the Goan lifestyle, which represents a sturdy colonial persuasion. Some of the famous dance forms of Goa consist of Dekni, Kunbi, Morulam and Zagor. People. The inhabitants of Goa are a jovial group of individuals who trust in living life completely with fun and rejoice. The laws of the state treat all religions equivalent, whereas women are provided ideal status similar to men in every sectors of life. The outgoing women wear Western outfits compared to men, who carry themselves with a specific degree of machine and prefer sports activities such as football and bullfighting. Also, the people of Goa are extremely friendly and happy-go-lucky. The citizens of Goa are of various faiths and create various cultural backgrounds, where they come together to make the life of Goa easygoing with an intention of better living. Other than the lifestyle of Goa, the inhabitants residing over there are also recognized for their colorful trend. With an advancement in trend, the traditional outfits are being tagged by designer labels, which on a trip to Goa one can purchase. Few of the excellent textile as well as embroidery work from different locations of the country. Food and cooking is prepared from different ingredients in Goan traditional style. In the coastal area, the Goan cuisine includes wide range of seafood like fish, mussels, prawns, crabs, oysters and various others. Also, the food cooked here is made in coconut oil. History. In 1498, Vasco da Gama became the first European to set foot in India through a sea route, landing in Kozhikode in Kerala, followed by an arrival in what is now known as Old Goa. The Portuguese arrived with the intention of setting up a colony and seizing complete control of the spice trade from other European powers. Later in 1510, the Portuguese admiral Afonso de Albuquerque defeated the ruling Bijapur kings on behalf of a local sovereign, Timmaya, leading to the establishment of a permanent settlement in Vela Goa. The Portuguese intended it to be a colony and a naval base district from the fortified enclaves established elsewhere along India's coasts. An interesting development of the 18th century in Goa is the conspiracy of the Pintos in 1787, which was inspired by the French Revolution. This was the first ethnic rebellion against Portuguese rule in Goa. After India gained independence from the British in 1947, Portugal refused to accede to India's request to relinquish their control of its exclave after arbitration by the United Nations General Assembly in the 1950s, the Indian Army moved in, uniting the colony with India. Most nations later recognized the annexation, and Portugal recognized it after its Carnation Revolution in 1974. In 1987, the Union territory was split and Goa was elevated as India's 25th state. Tourism and unique features of the state. Tourism and Goa are synonymous with each other. The Indian state of Goa, also known as the Pearl of the East, is known for its Gothic churches, age-old ruins, palm-fringed beaches, coconut groves, ferry rides, and bubbly folk music. With its 131-kilometer-long coastline, Goa is an important tourism destination in every tourist's itinerary. Goa is one of India's special tourism places, a state seemingly blessed with fabulous weather, even more fabulous beaches, delightful people, good food, hilltop forts, little whitewashed churches. Soaring Portuguese-era cathedrals are unique cultural legacy that make Goa as one of the India's prime tourism and holiday destinations. Bom Jesus Basilica is another famous attraction in Goa. Fort Agoda too is a major tourist attraction. Recently, a wax museum on the Indian history, culture and heritage has also been opened in Old Goa. The major tourist attractions in Goa are Fort Agoda and Candolim, Mapusa, Mud Goa, Old Goa, Panjim, Fonda, Vasco da Gama.
So far, we have seen only some salient features of the geography of the state. There are a lot more things to be studied about this state. We will see them in the future modules.